Now, another article that is division of the light segment in a given ratio, that is, suppose P and Q are two points in the space, the vertical P is x1 over 1, then 1, and the horizontal Q is x2 over 2, and then 2. R, the coordinate of R is x, y, and z, which divide the light segment PQ in the ratio of the ratio, okay, that is, this, the length between P and R is M, and we are, length between R and Q is M. Now, OP and OQ are two vectors considered from the origin passing through the point P, and OQ is a vector originated from point O passing through the point Q. The position vector of OP and OQ are x1 minus 0 along x axis, y1 minus 0 which is equal to y1 along y axis, and z1 minus 0 which is equal to z1 along z axis. Similarly, the position vector OQ is x2 minus 0 which is equal to x2 along x axis, y2 minus 0 which is equal to y2 along y axis, and z2 minus 0 which is equal to z2 along z axis. And the vector OR, the position vector of the vector OR is x minus 0 which is equal to x along x axis plus y minus 0 which is equal to y along y axis, and z minus 0 which is equal to z along z axis. Now, the vector OR is the resultant of the vector OP and PR. It's the resultant of the vector OP and PR by head-to-head rules. That is OR, the resultant of the vector OP plus PR. OR is equal to OP, and PR is now the R divided the length segment PQ in the ratio M ratio N, the total ratio is equal to M plus N, and this portion is equal to M. So this vector OPR, the vector PR is equal to M divided by M plus N of the total vector PQ. This vector PR is equal to the M divided by M plus N of the total vector PQ. Now, the direction ratio of the position vector of OR is x, y, z, and the direction, the position vector of OP is x1, y1, z1, and M divided by M plus N, and the direction ratio of PQ vector is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1, and this vector is already calculated in our previous lecture. Now, taking the LCM M plus N, so L1 divided by M plus N is common in these two terms. So multiply each direction ratio of the vector OP by m plus n multiplied by x1, m plus n multiplied by y1, m plus n multiplied by z1, plus multiply m with the direction ratio of the vector PQ. So m multiplied by x2 minus x1, m multiplied by y2 minus y1, and m multiplied by z2 minus z1. And what divided by m plus n is the LCM of these two vectors, which is common in these two vectors. Now, according to the condition of the sum of the vector and the corresponding elements of the direction ratio of these two vectors, we have 1 divided by m plus n, m multiplied by x1 plus m multiplied by x1 plus m multiplied by x2 minus m multiplied by x1, and m multiplied by y1 plus m multiplied by y1, and plus m multiplied by y2 minus m multiplied y1, and m multiplied by z1 plus n multiplied by z1 plus n multiplied by z2 minus n multiplied by z1. Now, cancel mx1 with mx1. We have nx1 plus mx2, and cancel my1 with my1. We have ny1 plus my2, and cancel mz1 with mz2. 1, and we have n z1 plus n z2. Now multiply the scalar 1 divided by n plus 1 to the direction ratio of this vector. We have n x1 plus n x2 divided by n plus 1, n y1 plus n y2 divided by n plus 1, and n z1 plus n z2 divided by n plus 1. Compare these two vectors, we have the value of x is equal to n x1 plus n x2 divided by n plus 1, the view, the direction of the vector y, y is equal to n y1 plus n y2 divided by n plus 1, and z is equal to n z1 plus n z2 divided by n plus n, which are the direction, which are the components of the point r, which divide the vector p cube in the ratio m ratio n. Now if r is if r divide the 9 segment p cube in 1 ratio, then we have to calculate the coordinate of the point r. Since the direction ratio, since the point r x y z divide the lines in the vector p q in the ratio m ratio n, therefore the coordinate of x y z are calculated in these steps. Now if m ratio n is equal to 1 ratio 1, this is the point r divide p q line segment in 1 ratio 1, that is r is the midpoint of p q, that is m ratio n is equal to 1 ratio 1. Then substitute the value m n in our previous, that is this ratio may be equal to 2, 3, 3. So after the calculation, it is 2 ratio 2. So after the calculation, the ratio is 2, and if this quantity is 3, 3, this is the ratio between these two quantities also equal to 1, 1, that is this point r is the midpoint of the line segment p q. So substitute these values in our given data, we have n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 1. After the calculation, the coordinate of the point r is r x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 divided by 2 plus y2 divided by 2, z1 plus z2 divided by 2, that is the point r divided by the line segment pq in the ratio 1 ratio 1, that is r is the midpoint of the line segment pq.